Devastation from the coronavirus pandemic is not evenly distributed. Although the disease seems to be deadlier to men, the economic fallout is hitting women harder. According to a recent National Bureau of Economic Research paper, there are two major reasons why this recession is tougher for women. First, this crisis has hit sectors where women's employment is concentrated, like retail, hospitality, even healthcare. The second reason is coronavirus shutdowns have closed schools and daycares. So the sudden loss of childcare makes it much harder for women who haven't lost their jobs to keep working. The most recent jobs report from the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics shows total non-farm payroll fell by 20.5 million last month. The unemployment rate increased by 10.3 percentage points to 14.7%. That's the highest rate and the largest over-the-month increase in the history of these reports. Looking at that data more closely, for men 16 and older, it was 13.3%, but it was 15.7% for women. The picture looks even more troubling among women of color. Broken down by race, unemployment for white women was 14.6%, while it was 15.8% for black women and 19.8% for Hispanic and Latina women. It should be noted that these numbers are not seasonally adjusted, but a big picture can still be drawn. Job losses were most severe in leisure and hospitality. 7.7 million jobs were lost. A similar picture is happening in the UK. Women were about one-third more likely to work in a sector affected by the shutdowns. And who makes up the essential workforce? There's some ambiguity about whether certain types of workers should be classified as essential or not, and those definitions have been changing throughout the crisis. The NBER paper found that 17% of employed women in the US work in critical occupations, mostly in healthcare, compared to 24% of employed men. This may mean that men's jobs are more protected, even though their health is at greater risk. Then there's the school closures. According to UNESCO, over 70% of the world's student population has been impacted. This is especially problematic for single parents, and there are far more single moms than single dads. In OECD countries, 16% of children live in single-parent homes, and that's overwhelmingly with their mothers. Shutdowns also mean more housework, and for decades, women and heterosexual couples have done the majority of this unpaid work. Data from the UK showed that in 2015, women did, on average, 30.6 hours of unpaid work a week, while men did 17.5. Having to do even more unpaid work at home does not bode well for women's career progression or their future earning potential. But the coronavirus crisis doesn't have to reinforce this lopsided arrangement. Historically, disruptions like this have led to lasting social and economic change. That could happen now if policymakers design recovery efforts with gender in mind, if employers maintain flexible remote work hours, and if fathers pick up more of the childcare and housework.